Hey everyone, welcome to Binge Bar. The Pittsburgh Penguins' dream of three-peating last season in the playoffs was quickly shut down in the second round due to the division rivals and future Stanley Cup champions, the Washington Capitals. Until that moment, that other stomach-turning, heart-shattering, dream-destroying moment in overtime, the Pens were still a force on the ice that other teams feared to face. They were still a team of passion, talent, and dignity. Evgeny Kuznetsov's goal was the moment where it all went wrong. Today, we would like to talk about the Pittsburgh Penguins, the end of an era. As I was saying prior, the Penguins had everything it took at achieving another cup to complete their dynasty and their reign over the National Hockey League. They had just as good of a chance, if not better, than most teams in the league for that fact. Of course, prior to their reign, they still had the core group of Sidney Crosby, Evgeny Malkin, Chris Letang, and Marc-Andre Fleury between the pipes. For the 2015-2016 season, they made a trade that would forever change their franchise, and that was the trade with the Toronto Maple Leafs for your very own Phil Kessel, or for today's video, the former Phil the Thrill. With trades enabling them to acquire Phil Kessel, Ian Cole, Nick Bonino, Carl Hagelin, and Justin Schultz, along with the youth they had blossoming featuring Brian Rust, Connor Sheary, Daniel Sprong, and of course, the one who made it all happen, goaltender Matt Murray, turned the Pens into possibly the greatest team in the NHL at that time. The Bergs stormed through the next two seasons being this unstoppable brute force, winning back-to-back cups. Along the way, they lost players in free agency and goaltender Marc-Andre Fleury in the expansion draft to Vegas. But they recovered rather fast, and they were looking still sharp on the ice. Going into the 2017-2018 season is where things took a dark turn. They had an on and off season in terms of consistency and injuries, and as the trade deadline approached, a few notable names were shipped out while others were acquired. Biggest name joining the team being Derek Brassard, supposed to be the answer they needed, the third line center they oh so needed after the departure of Nick Bonino. They also brought in Riley Sheahan, Jamie Oleksiak, and even Josh Joris. So what's wrong, what's the problem, and what happened next? Dreams die hard. Since the dawn of time, it was always a given. The Pittsburgh Penguins were to defeat the Washington Capitals in the playoffs every single year. But not this time. This time was different, and as I said in the beginning of the video, it was the late overtime goal from Evgeny Kuznetsov who haunts the minds of Pittsburgh fans everywhere as he single-handedly eliminated them. Similar to the Chris Kunitz overtime goal against the Senators the year prior, crippling and dismantling the Ottawa Senators franchise, this goal from Evgeny Kuznetsov did the same to the Pittsburgh Penguins. The window had shrunk, and the clock on the Pens was ticking, but there was still next year to take this group and do what they strived to do the year before. The 2018-2019 season began, and trouble embraced each and every player that put on that uniform. A plague of failure had the Pens wrapped around its finger. GM Jim Rutherford, who formerly built this all-star team, decided it was finally time to tear them down almost as fast as he created them. Connor Sheary is dealt to Buffalo in the offseason to quote-unquote clear cap space. A few days later, an aging gritty fossil known as Jack Johnson from the Columbus Blue Jackets signs a $3 million 5-year contract. Speaking of fossils, a mid-40-year-old joins the group one more time. The man, the myth, the dad, Matt Cullen. Season begins and before you know it, Carl Hagelin is dealt away for Tanner Pearson for the LA Kings. Not too bad, just hurts a little. Then Pearson is traded for Erica Branson from the Canucks, and Hagelin is now traded once again from the Kings to the Capitals. Now it hurts a lot, and you think it's almost over. And Derek Brassard, along with Riley Sheahan, is traded to Florida for Nick Bjugstad and Jared McCann. At least this trade we all like. There is finally a light at the end of the tunnel for this team. But then you trade Daniel Sprong to the Ducks for Marcus Pettersson. And while Pettersson is a great fit, really? Daniel Sprong? This is the sole reason this team has lost all of its youth and now fears for the future. I get it, I know, I understand that Daniel Sprong was struggling, but you have to look at it this way. The Penguins have absolutely no prospects. They have one of the worst prospects pools in the NHL, so trading Daniel Sprong does nothing but hurt the team. And now things are finally starting to click. Things are looking better for the team, and then the playoffs begin. First round, New York Islanders at Nassau Coliseum. You're swept. You are swept by a team who missed the playoffs by 17 points last season and went on to lose star player and captain John Tavares in the offseason to the Toronto Maple Leafs. Granted, this is an Isles club behind former Stanley Cup champions Washington Capitals coach Barry Trotz. But even with that, you managed to hang on to your lead in these games for a combined total of just under 5 minutes. No fight, no determination, and no passion shown on the ice to even attempt to win these games. And that's where we are today. And it all comes down to one thing, and that's your coach, Mike Sullivan. but we're going to get to that. But now, as of today, the Penguins GM has said the only two names on the roster that are untouchable are Crosby and Malkin. So expect big changes. Expect very big changes. Phil Kessel and Chris Letang could very well be moved this offseason. Patrick Hornquist's contract isn't looking like too much of a bargain anymore, and Matt Murray certainly has the heat on him from just about everyone. It's a scary time to be a fan of the Pittsburgh Penguins. So from here on in, I'd like to share my opinion on all of this. Despite 95% of fans of the Pens, I don't blame Matt Murray and think we should have kept Marc-Andre Fleury in the expansion draft. I don't think it's fair to blame Murray after all he has done here and all he has gone through in his personal life. Aside from injuries and the passing of his own father, Matt still brought two cups to the city in his first two seasons here as a rookie. The reason the Pens lose games is a combination of two things: lack of offensive scoring and a weak, crippling defense. Murray had a good season, don't at me. Changes have to be made to this group this offseason, I agree with that. But touching Murray would be such a huge mistake for this franchise to do. And being completely honest, the same thing can go for Chris Letang too. I know Tanger has struggled, but he is one of the hardest workers on the ice. And we already let Carl Hagelin go. I don't think we're going to want to let Letang go too. Now for the trades that I think need to be done as soon as possible are Phil Kessel and Olli Maatta. I'd love to see Johnson moved, but I just don't see it happening. Kessel lost his will to win games. He got his two rings, and it just looks like he stopped caring. Olli Maatta is probably the worst thing I have ever seen attempt to do anything ever, so he has to go now. Now, the biggest problem of all is our coach, Mike Sullivan. Sullivan came in and coached us to two Stanley Cups. We can't take that away from him, but that was the past. It's time to focus on tomorrow, and that's not happening with him around. Sullivan is so stuck in his ways, he refuses to change or try anything different despite the league changing so rapidly. This team is going to look like the LA Kings by next season if it doesn't make moves fast. But by the end of the day, this is still a team that has Sidney Crosby and Evgeny Malkin on it. So despite most of the people in the league, I don't think this team is done. Despite any changes they make this offseason, this team can come back and win the Cup next year for all we know. The whole league had them down in 2015, but they came back and won two Stanley Cups. So what does that show? It shows that when you have two of the greatest players in the whole entire world on your team, anything is possible. Until then, I guess the only thing that we can do is wait. If you enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe for more content. Thank you. We'll see you next time.